Hi guys, it's me, Zeta, Zeta Hot Fabulous Pink, and today I'm going to be doing Peter Pan. So in Peter Pan, there's this lady called Kathy Rigby. Now she's the lady who played Peter Pan, the musical. So I'm going to be showing you my dancing and my singing and some talking of her. But the other people are going to be doing their part, and I'm going to be doing her part. So I hope you like it. And one thing, I'm going to be maybe doing some songs, or maybe I'm not. So here we go.
Tinkerbell. Tink! Oh, hello! Oh. Hello! Tinkerbell. Tink! Oh, Tink. Where are you? There you are. Do you come to the house? Tinkerbell, do you know where they put it? Which drawer? Oh, come on, hurry up. This one. My shadow. Oh, stick. Shadow. Stick. No. All right, shadow. I'll stick you on with soap. What's your name?
Wendy Moira Angela Darling. What's your name?
Peter Pan.
Is that all?
Yes.
I'm so sorry.
Doesn't matter.
Where do you live?
Second star to the right and straight on till morning.
Oh, what a funny address.
No, it isn't.
I mean, is that what they put on your letters?
Don't get any letters.
But your mother gets letters.
Don't have a mother.
Oh, Peter.
You mustn't touch me.
Why?
No one has ever touched me.
Why not?
I don't know.
Well, no wonder you were crying.
I wasn't crying about mothers. I just can't get my shadow to stick on.
Your shadow has come off?
It's dead.
Oh, how awful.
Just dead.
Peter, you've been trying to stick it on with soap.
Well, then.
Well, it must be sewn on.
Oh, it's sewn.
Dreadfully ignorant.
No, I'm not.
I shall sew it on for you, my little man.
All right.
But first we'll need a little more light. There.
Oh. Look at this.
Now, who's there?
Oh. Over there.
Yes. All right.
All right.
Oh, I dare say this will hurt a little.
I never cry.
Thank you.
myself, and I see myself, all the wonderful things that I see. If I'm pleased with myself, I have every good reason to be. I got a crow. I'm just the cleverest fella, the more of my fortune to know. I'm down the top of my shells, I'm on the tip of my toes. I got a crow. I got a brag. I just stay in my fingers and need a bagel and rag. I tell my friends and I have it with the battles below. I got a crow. If I were a fairy, ordinary, everyday face, I'd never be heard. Cock-a-doodle and howl like a bird. So naturally, and I lie inside me just tickles me so that I gotta let go and crow. All right.
Don't you know what a kiss is?
Alone, when you give it to me. A kiss. Oh, now I should give you a kiss.
If you please.
All right. All right. Oh. Here. There.
There. Oh, a button, yes.
Yes.
I shall wear it on this chain around my neck.
All right. Come on.
What?
How
old are you?
I don't know. Quite young, I guess. I ran away from home the day I was born.
Ran away? Why?
Because when my father and mother learned when I was a bee, when I became a man. I was a little boy. And have fun. So I ran away.
And I've lived a long time among the fairies.
Peter, do you really know fairies?
Yes, they're nearly all dead
now. Dead? What's wrong?
Children know so long now. They'll believe. And in time, the child says, I don't believe in fairies. Someplace, somewhere, a fairy falls down dead. Ah! She's gone. Tinkerbell! Tink!
You know if you do tell me there is a fairy right here in this room.
No, she came here with me. Shh, shh. You don't hear anything, do you?
No. The only sound I hear is like the tinkle of a bell.
Stink! That's the fairy language.
It seems to come from over there.
Wendy, I believe I shut her up in that drawer. Sorry, I was supposed to shut her up in that drawer.
What did she say?
She's not very polite. She said, you're a great ugly girl, she's mine. Shh! Tinkerbell, you can't be my fairy. Because I am a gentleman and you are a lady. She said, you silly ass. She's quite a common girl, you know. She's never been to mention of a big pots and kettles. No! No! No!
It's all right. She's still chained up. Come on out.
place.
Please tell me.
Would you believe me? I mean, if I told you. For sure?
For sure.
I have a place where dreams are born and time is never planned. It's not very hard, you must find it in your heart. Never, never land. It might be miles beyond the moon, or right there where you stand. Just linger in mind, and then suddenly you'll find Never, Never Land. You'll have a treasure if you stay there, more precious far than gold. For what you have found your way there, you can. Dreams are born and time is never planned. Just think of lovely things and your heart will fly on wings forever in Never, Never Land.
What does it look like, Peter?
Oh, it's an island, Wendy.
A large one?
No, quite small.
A lovely grand little thing of a dream. An adventure and another. And it's summer and winter and spring and fall, all at the same time and different parts of the island.
Oh, I wish I could see it.
But you can, Wendy. Close your eyes tight. Now, what do you see?
I see a pool of lovely pale colors.
Ease and tighter.
Yes.
Tighter.
Yes.
And every time it takes on shape, and then colors will become brighter. In the moment they'll go on fire, and in that moment, just before they do, that's it, Wendy. That's my island. You have a treasure if you stay there, more precious far than gold. For what you have found your way there, you can. My home where dreams are born and time is never planned. Just think of lovely things and your heart will fly on wings forever in Never, Never Land.
Boys.
Who are they? The children have fallen under the carriages. And the nurses are looking the other way. But they're not claimed in 7 days. Neverland. I'm captain, you know.
Oh, what fun it must be.
Yes. Well, we are lonely. Oh? Are the other companionship?
And none of the others' girls?
No. You know, not much for Clive to follow up their carriages.
Peter, it's perfectly lovely the way you talk about girls. John there just despises us.
Oh.
Oh.
He does he?
Yes.
All right. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, no, wicked.
Just...
You're not captain here.
Sorry.
You meant to be kind. You may give me a kiss.
I thought you wanted it back. Here.
I didn't mean a kiss.
Oh?
I mean a thimble.
What is that?
It's like this.
What is it?
It's exactly as if someone were pulling my hair.
That's Tink. She doesn't like them. Stop it.
She
She says if you do that, you give me a thimble.
Why?
I don't know. Why, Tink?
She said your silly ass again.
She's very impertinent.
Stop it. Go home.
Why did you come to our nursery window?
See, the stories. None of us knows any stories.
Perfectly awful.
Wendy, your mother was telling you a really lovely story.
Which story is it?
About the prince. And he couldn't find the lady who wore the glass slipper. Pockets.
Oh, it's awfully fascinating.
Yes.
Would you teach John and Michael to fly too?
Oh, if you like.
John, Michael, wake up. There's a boy here who's going to teach us to fly. Quick, someone's coming out of the light sweat. You see, Nana, they're sound asleep in beds now, aren't they? Just listen to their gentle breathing. Come along, little dog. Come on.
All clear!
Come on! Can you really fly?
I'll teach you!
Oh, how lovely to fly!
Teacher, I jumped on the wind's back, and away we'll go! Wendy, when you're sleeping in your silly bed, you may fly about with me, saying funny things to the stars.
How'd you do it?
Oh, you just think lovely, wonderful thoughts, and up you go!
I'm flying.
Leave me way up high, suddenly.
Michael,
get ready! Tinkerbell, come on! Hurry up and follow!